Hi, today I'm explaining about another tool in Animate CC. Okay, yes, in the previous class we discussed about line tool. Okay, today we are discussing about rectangle tool and rectangle primitive tool. Okay, so what are these tools actually? So these are very common normal tool, like in Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop we have rectangle tools. Okay, so suppose if you draw the shape here, rectangles, you can create them. Okay, so easily we can create them rectangles. Okay, so these rectangles, suppose the settings are here, different settings. I'll change this in default the settings. I have to check this. Reset. Yes. No. Yes. This is our rectangle. Okay. With the left mouse, you can click and drag. Suppose you want complete rectangle horizontally, rectangle shape, or otherwise. A vertical rectangle, you can draw this. Okay, but here you can use shift to, okay, so proper squares, square shapes you'll get. Okay, so by pressing shift you'll get square shapes. Okay, and without pressing shift you draw your freehand rectangles. Okay. Right. Then suppose I'll delete this. Yes. Suppose this is my rectangle. By using shift I'm creating. Okay. After that keyboard, the arrow keys are there. Okay, if you press this arrow key, okay, so particularly that up arrow key, so these the shortcuts, this shape, rectangle shape, is changing into this different shape here. Okay, so press down arrow, so down arrow, you click this, so this is coming into a normal. Suppose if I click step by step, it is changing into that. So press up arrow, this is giving this shape. Okay, from that shape if you give down arrow, you are releasing that. Releasing that. Okay, and suppose the same down arrow, click and hold that, so it is going to be a rectangle, but rounded corners. It is giving this rounded corners. Suppose, see, this is rounded corners, and suppose press up arrow, and it is releasing your round corners. See, and continuously click on that again, it is changing into that first shape. Okay, so these are okay. So These are the shortcuts. Okay. I'll delete and again I'll draw this. Reset any values. The previous values, if you don't want, you can reset on that. So simply get your actual shape. See there, still it is there. So what I'm doing, yes, this is now the perfect the square boxes. Right. Yes, these are the simple square and rectangle boxes creation. Okay, so now you can change this line width. Suppose here you have the line width here. Okay, and if you observe here these corners, suppose if you click on this bevel, see instead of this round corner, this kind of the flatness it is giving. And suppose this is a melter, so melter has complete the sharp edges it is giving. Sometimes you want melter, sometimes you want bevel, and sometimes you want round corners. So in default you can leave it in melter, right? Okay, then here suppose this value I'll give it to something like 50. Okay, now here we have different line styles are also there. Just you can click on that, your line is converting into different border like. Okay, just you can click on them, nice border it is creating. See, these are actually brushes. Okay, you can take from here, or otherwise there are another the widthness are there, width brushes. Okay, so this is normal again. And suppose here the same for line width, here we have the options. Suppose the direction or art appears from left to right, so the direction itself it is showing, arranging from here to here. If you click on this, okay, it goes, see it changing. Suppose in default you can click on that. So flip artwork means it can flip left or right side and right left side. Okay. So these are the widthness, minimum widthness, same like we used already with the line tool. Okay, so these are not new. Okay, and here suppose, yeah, these are brush. So these are the brushes. So here we have different brushes are there. So you can click on that, your brush is changing into arrow mark. Otherwise you can click on that, this edge, the edge is changing into the arrow standard. And here it is artistic. In artistic again the charcoals already we used from that library, and here it has the ink. Okay, so inkness, ink, the thickness, here it is adding. Okay, and it is paintbrush. The from paintbrush again you can choose whatever the, see it is look like a border, it is creating border. And this is a scroll pen. Okay, line strokes are available, and here the decorative borders, the banners, like see sometimes we use this elegant. So these are different drop downs. There are different shapes from the brushes, and here the text dividers. Suppose you give this, see, it is nice border adding, very nice, interesting. Suppose this is your artwork, okay, along with artwork you can create a nice border, you can take whatever you like. This is, suppose this is there, the different borders, and here it is line art. So these are already we used. So pattern brushes, from pattern brushes borders, see, this is very nice, interesting. Excellent. You can change this border into the border color into your interesting color. Suppose you just, you can click on that and use this border. Excellent. And suppose you can delete this inside color, and this is my border. And you can suppose Control C, Control Shift V, okay, and suppose this is the another border, this is another border. Now I'm giving a nice color to this. Here it is. And suppose here it is something like white. See, these are beautiful. Okay. And here you can change the color also, the border color. Instead of this, we use this yellow. Yeah. Yellow. Fresh yellow. And get these two, select and make it group. Okay, otherwise Control G. Okay, so Control G. So this is grouped. And now see, this border, very nice. So the same way you can choose from brush library, whatever your border can be, you can change according to that. Yeah, because it is grouped, so can make it ungroup. Okay, so suppose click on that and from modify. Okay, so already grouped, ungroup, so that both are divided. Okay, and you can select this and apply that border. So this is a different border, this is simply nice. Okay, so otherwise you can click on this, select this and you click on this. No, this is good. Yes, okay, perfect. The same way here, from the vector packs, so hand drawn brushes, these are like strokes. Okay, so different brushes, strokes you can apply to your shape, rectangle shape. Yes, next suppose here you can draw here. Yeah, now in default it is coming again, so what I'll do, can change this into a normal brush. Sorry. Change this into normal brush. Style, it is just normal. Yes, yes, perfect. Okay, now right. So then here, so what you do, you can change this. Suppose I'll delete this. In the inside hidden there are other tool is also there, rectangle primitive tool. So with this you can create a rectangle. Okay, after creating this, just you can give the values. Okay, the same thing we used the shortcuts by up arrow and down arrow. Okay, so this is minus up arrow, okay, and this is plus down arrow. So here the values are changing. Okay, after changing this, if you don't like this, you can make it reset. So automatically this is coming into zero values, rectangle corner radius. So then your shape will get back. Okay, so this is the primitiveness, or otherwise simply by selecting the this direct sub selection tool. So this is the selection tool with the use this directly with this sub selection tool. Okay, you can move this point. So this is anchor, so you can pull this, so automatically it is changing into a round, a circle. Okay, see the value itself, it is changing. Okay, so after drawing this, select the sub selection tool, and with these points you can drag them, you can open this, you are changing your shape into actual your rectangle box, your square box, or otherwise if you pull inside, these points are matching each other and remaining showing only four points and giving a round. Suppose here you can change any color. Yeah, round. Okay, keep this side. Yes, next again you draw here. Suppose here again this is giving the same the roundness here, because reset the value so that you will get a normal. Okay, yeah, so in this we have two tools, a rectangle tool and rectangle primitive tool. Okay, so and again what you do, draw this, I'll change this, the thickness at least 25. Yes, this is my box. Okay, and I don't want a fill, this is my box. And more on that, I'm giving one more box. Okay, so here the two boxes one by one overlapped. Okay, so you can drag these two boxes. Okay, and from modify, okay, suppose here you can convert this into swap bitmaps. I'll explain later this. So you can break apart. Break apart means again your object drawing mode convert into merge drawing mode, or otherwise convert to symbol. You can convert that. Okay, about symbols I'll explain later. Convert to bitmap, so it can change it into a JPEG like the bitmap image. Okay, and here the symbols, leave it for symbol. And shape, smooth shape, and convert to lines to fills. These are in the expand fill, I'll explain later. Okay, and here suppose combined object, you can check here. So union, so this whole shape is combined into one. See, if I select one shape, the both are selecting. Okay, so next control Z, so you can divide this into normal, yeah, divided. Now select combinedly these two and from modify. Okay, and what you do, you can intersect, so that control Z, so this is intersecting, modify intersecting. Okay, and here in the modify, suppose here punch, control Z, it is not taking that. I'll do again. You can select this from modify, combine object. Just a minute, it is not taking this. So these are the overlapped objects, good. And right click also you will get. Select this, modify, combine object, intersect, it is not taking. Yes, I'll try here, replace in another layer. This is one and this is another one, so you can drag these two. That means you are selecting these two and modify, combine object, intersect. So both are. So what I'll do here, reset classic. Yeah, reset classic. Black, because the shapes can intersect each other, but now these are not connecting, this and this, and modify, combine and intersect. Yes, now it is intersecting. Suppose here punch, yes, perfect. So these are the two objects, okay, overlapped each other. So I'm selecting by pressing shift to two shapes at a time. I'm selecting and modify and combine objects. So suppose union means those two objects can be one only. Suppose intersect means the intersecting that particular area, this piece only. Okay, now from modify again, punch means, okay, so there will be a hole like it is taking. Okay, and control Z, and again from modify, okay, and crop, see only that part remains, the other than other part is vanishing. Okay, so and again suppose here I fill with a different color. Suppose this I want to send back. So for that, from timeline, they transform, arrange. Yeah, arrange. Already front it is there. Send to back. You can send it back. Or otherwise, in right click also the options are there. Arrange. Okay. And suppose you can send it back the red. Okay. Send back. And suppose So next what we'll do, you can select these two, and select this two, and right click here, and suppose here there is option distribute to layers. If you click this, okay, so these two boxes arranging in two separate layers, okay, arranging in two separate layers. Now these two, suppose first these are in the same layer. Now select these two and right click and distribute to layers, so that if you observe here, the two shapes separated in two separate layers. Okay, so that is, okay, and now again you can right click and distribute to keyframes. Okay, so distribute to keyframes means, suppose continuously displayed into one by one frames, see here and here. Okay, so about these things I'll explain clearly about keyframes and all. Okay, but today just you can observe this. Okay, these are simple tools actually, but we have to experiment. Okay, so today we use the rectangle tool and rectangle primitive tool. You also can experiment with different brushes and different shapes of the brushes, okay, and styles of the brushes and width, okay, and you can choose from brush library, and you can change the join, okay, so define how to path segments. And in this again we have a rectangle primitive, so with that give the value decrease and increase, so that the shape will get into differently, get behave into differently, or otherwise you can use on keyboard up arrow and down arrow, so that it changes its shapes. Okay, so this is your today's class, the simple class actually, so I don't want to give many don't want to add many tools at a time, because you also have to learn slowly, step by step. Okay, right, so today's class, rectangle and rectangle primitive tool. You just practice this, and if you have any doubt, please ask. Okay, thank you.